Greetings, Lexicons, and welcome to Minecraft 1.5, the Redstone update in a nutshell, where I'm going to try and cover everything that's been added in this new update in as little time as possible so you can spend more time playing. So let's jump straight in. Firstly, you've probably already noticed a lack of a texture pack button. This has now been moved to the options section, which also means that you can now change texture packs inside of the game. Smooth lighting now has three settings: off, minimum, and maximum. The minimum setting is the same as the on setting as before 1.5, and the new maximum setting is a new type of lighting engine which has been implemented, but it does make world generation a lot slower, so it's perhaps something that you should only be using if you have a high powered computer. Animated textures have been added into the game. Now, I've already done a video on this, so if you want to check this out, just click an annotation on the video somewhere now. You can now clean up random small stacks of the same item by double clicking on one of those items to put them all into a single stack. By clicking and dragging with the right mouse button, you can now put one of those items into each slot, or using the left mouse button to spread the stack evenly. Death messages have now been tweaked to account for new things such as mob naming. Redstone comparators have been added, which offer different strength redstone signals depending on the different application in which it's used. They can tell you how many items have been placed into a chest, can give you different strength results depending on what music disc you're listening to in a jukebox, and can also tell you, with the help of detector rails, how many items are inside a storage chest cart, such as a minecart with chest or minecart with hopper. Naming a spawn egg and placing down a mob or animal can give them a name above their head. This means we now see the return of testificates. Yay! You can now equip armor by shift-clicking the items inside of the UI, or by right-clicking the armor whilst holding it. Chests in abandoned mineshafts are now chests in carts inside of mineshafts. Dispensers can now deploy ignited TNT. Oh no! Bone meal can now also be used in the same way to help grow plants. And for the destructive amongst you, you can also use flint and steel to make fires. And if you have armor inside of them, they can even be used to dress you up in armor. They can now also be placed in all six directions, including from the top and bottom. A daylight sensor has been added, which gives you different strengths redstone signal depending on what time of day it is. A redstone block has been added, which can be pushed by pistons and can give different items power. A new quartz ore has been added, which can only be mineable from the nether. This means new blocks, including the quartz block, chiseled quartz block, a directional pillar quartz block, quartz stairs, and quartz slabs, which has given us the possibility to all new great creations, such as this one. A new traps chest has been added, which gives a redstone signal upon being opened, and its strength can change depending on how many people have that chest open at the same time. A new hopper block has been added, which gives you the opportunity to transport items between chests and other type of storage devices. Two new types of weighted pressure plates have been added, including a light pressure plate, which has a pressure depending up to 60 items, and can give a redstone signal depending on how many items have been thrown to it, and a heavy strength weighted pressure plate, which has a sensitivity of up to 922 items. Minecarts with TNT have been added, along with activator rails, which allow for the TNT to be set off by the rail and then explode. The track that they are on will not be affected. Minecart with hoppers have also been added, which can also be triggered on and off by an activator rail. Droppers have been added to counter the dispenser's new productivity, so you can also throw things out such as TNT and arrows without actually firing them. They can also be used to place items in adjacent storage blocks. And like with dispensers, they can now be placed in all six directions, including up and down. Snow can now be placed with variable block heights. Bone meal can now take several chances in order to actually grow a plant or tree. And mob difficulties have been changed, which now includes better aiming for skeletons. And there we have it, Minecraft 1.5 in a nutshell. If you've enjoyed this video, please let me know by rating, commenting, and subscribing. Don't forget that you can check me out on Facebook and Twitter, and also Instagram. Check the links in the description below. But thank you very much for watching, everyone, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye!